Hey learner, this is Nilesh Borate. We have discussed the swapping of two number by third variable without third variable, then square root of a given number, then print the power of two numbers and print the ASCII value of a given character. Okay, so first we have to go for the swapping of two numbers. So swapping 1.c, this is my first program. So this hash include stdio.h. In that main method, I can use two variables x and y. Printf, enter two numbers, scanf %d %d and x comma and y. Okay. So what is the meaning of swapping? Swapping means they interchange the value between the two variables. Okay, so how to do that? So there is a need of a third variable. So I can define one third variable is a temp. So assign temp equal to x, x equal to y, and y equal to temp. So this is my logic. So after this logic, I can print x equal to %d and y equal to %d. Okay, here I can x and y both value will be printed, then test the code by using the compiler. Okay, so here I can pass the two values 5 and 6. So x equal to 6 and y equal to 5, both value will be the interchange. So how this is work? If the x value is the 5 and the y value is the 6, so here I can accept the two values from keyboard x and y. So these are my three sentences. First one is that the temp equal to x. So here I can assign the value of x is equal to temp. So temp equal to 5. Next sentence is that the x equal to y. So x assign the value of y. The value of y is the 6. So x is equal to 6. And then last sentence is that the y equal to temp. So assign the value of temp to y. So what is the value of temp? Temp value is the 5, so assign this to y. So here they interchange the value in between the x and y. So my input is the 5 and 6 and the output is the 6 and 5. So this is my logic. Okay, same program I can do for the different logic. So what is the different logic is that, so swapping of two number without using the third variable means you cannot use the third variable. So only use two variable x and y, accept two numbers x and y. So how to swap them? If I can use the x equal to y and y equal to x, so this is the incorrect logic, because see that what happened. Compile and run. If you pass the two number 5 and 6, the value is the 6 and 6, the 5 will be the missing. Okay, so this is my incorrect logic. So what we can do that here, some addition rule, that is x is equal to x plus y, then y is equal to x minus y, and x is equal to x minus y. Test this logic, compile and run. Two numbers 5 and 6, here these two numbers will be swapping. So how this code will work? Here value of x is equal to 5 and value of y is equal to 6. Here I can accept the two numbers from keyboard. Then these three statements. First one is that x is equal to x plus y, that is the 5 plus 6 is equal to 11, means the value of x is the 11. This is the new value of x, not using the previous value. Okay, then second sentence is that y equal to the x minus y. So here you can use the new value of x is that the 11 minus, and y value is the 6. 11 minus 6 is equal to 5, so y is equal to 5. Now you can use the new value of y, and the last is that the x equal to x minus y. So x value is the 11, y value is the 5, so 11 minus 5 is equal to 6, so x is equal to 6. So here you can see that the x and y will be the interchange. Okay, So this is the another logic to swapping of two number. Okay. Next we can see that the square root of a given number and the power of two numbers. Okay. I can give the program name sq√c. Okay. Okay, you can use one header file stdio.h. inside this you can pass. So there is a built-in function for calculating the square root. For that function you can add one header file. So this name of header file is that the math.h. in that header file the all the mathematics related functions are defined. So first I can accept one number from keyboard, enter any number, and the answer is stored in my float value, because some numbers cannot have the square root. For example, the square root of 9 is the 3 and the square root of 10 is the point value. So that's why I can use the float variable. So answer is equal to sqrt of x. Sorry, first scanf the value percent d comma x, then answer is equal to square root of x. I can print the answer. Answer is equal to percent f, because my variable is in float. Okay, so test this code. I can compile the code. See that in Linux operating system, if you compile the mathematics related libraries, so not affected, because you can pass the extra parameter minus lm. Lm means that the link the math library externally. So here the program will be the compiled. So test the code, enter any number, 9 number, so square root of 9 is the 3, and if you can pass the 10, the square root of 10 is a 3.162278. okay, so same we can how to find the power. So again hash include stdio.h, then int main. Here you can use the two variables, because there is need to find. Here you can use the two variables, then printf, enter two numbers, scanf, %d%d, sorry, and a and x comma and y. Next answer is stored. Answer is stored in extra variable ans. Here ans is equal to pow. This is the built-in function to finding the power x comma y. So here x raised to y will be calculated and the result is stored in a ans. Then answer is equal to percent d comma ans. Okay, then you can add the return 0. So test the code, compile. Here also get some undefined reference error. You can also pass here the minus lm. Minus lm means link maths library. Okay, so this is also error, that because we cannot add the one header file math.h. okay, math.h. okay, then compile this code, then run. Two number, 2, 3, so 2 raised to 3 is 8. Okay, okay, so last program is that the ASCII value ASCII.c. so hash include stdio.h, then this is my main method. Here I can return 0. Okay, so first one accept character, so char ch printf, enter any character. In previous video we can already see that what is the character set. So character can be accepted by using the percent c. okay, so in C language the small letter, capital letter, digits, symbols, all are the characters. Every character has the ASCII value. So how to print the ASCII value. If you print the character is equal to percent C, then you can see that what is the character you can be accepted. And here if print ASCII value is equal to, just print this character in percent D. If you print the character in percent D, automatically ASCII value will be the printed. There is a no need to logic, okay. So here I can pass the slash n for printing the output in separate lines. So compile this code, compile and run. Here the capital A character, the ASCII is 65. Again, small a is the 97, then 0 is the 48, okay. So here you can also pass the dollar is the 36, space is also character. The value of space is the 32, dot, comma. So every symbol have some ASCII value, okay. So if you have the any queries related to this topic, then please comment on your query in comment box. Guys, please like and subscribe the channel. Keep learning and do hard work. See you guys on next video. Thank you.